Now, Solidarity has today launched a knowledge bank on its website. Here, trained engineers, artisans and experts who were previously employed by Eskom can register to return to the power utility. The union has also weighed on the current crisis at the power utility. For more on this, we chat to CEO of Solidarity, Dirk Hermann, who joins us on the line. Dirk, thank you so much for your time. Are you not a little bit worried then, and we'll get into the whole point of the knowledge bank itself, are you not worried that getting this to work and get other people to return to Eskom is counter to the fears that we have about employees at Eskom actually losing their jobs?
At this stage, there's some skill shortages in Eskom, especially on the engineering level and artisans level. So what we say is where the shortages, we must recruit skilled specialists from abroad. And what we do is we follow up on a call from Minister Gordhan, where he said that it's important to recruit the top engineers around the world to help us to turn around Eskom. And I think we must now say that we have a national crisis, and we must see Eskom as a national project, and everyone must now try and get involved in trying to turn around. And this is our offer from Solidarity side, to say let's look at where's the shortages at this stage, which kind of skills do we need, and then let's recruit those skills and we fill it. The irony at this stage is that, well, there's some people that say that there's too many workers in Eskom. We say that's not the problem. We say that that there is a skill shortage in Eskom. It sounds like a paradox, but the fact of the matter is that we have a problem at this stage with the highly technical skills, and we want to help to turn that around.
Will your knowledge bank, Mr. Hermann, then also help not just in hiring new people, but also in ascertaining which skills are exactly necessary for Eskom? There are fears, even by international bodies as well, saying that Eskom is perhaps over overcapacity with regards to the number of people it has. So will this knowledge bank be able to help in ascertaining the right number for Eskom, and just how we can go about making sure that it is efficient and effective?
No, we must go further than the knowledge bank to do that, and that is why we call for a skills audit in Eskom, so that we can know exactly where's the shortages at this stage, and that is necessary as well. The knowledge bank at this stage is just to provide skills, to give people an opportunity to register internationally in South Africa, all Eskom workers to say, here we are, we want to help, we are patriotic to the country, we want to come back, and we want to help to build Eskom. And that is the focus of the skills bank, and that is to help Minister Gordhan. The fact of the matter is a trade union like us have the network across the country. Our ex-members are now the people that Gordhan wants, and he doesn't have access to them. We have. And that is why we say let's help them to bring them back.
What do you make of the current crisis then at Eskom, the constant rolling blackouts, which were of keen surprise to many South Africans, and the level at which it's at, even going up to around 40% of our capacity even being cut down?
It's absolutely a crisis. That's fundamental. There's big, big structural problems. Even unbundling is not the answer. The answer is much bigger than this. And that is why we say is that in the short time, we must see it as a national project. Everyone must help to turn it around, because it's a real, real threat to the economy of South Africa. But there's another element as well, and that is that we as workers are furious about the mess, and we want to help, and we will our workers will do what they can to keep the lights on. But the fact of the matter is we've seen a whole structural problem in Eskom that involves bad management, that involved bloated contracts, and what we say is that we actually need a commission of inquiry that can look at that. We say that we've seen looters at Eskom, they got scot-free, and we as workers and the general public in South Africa must pay the price.
So, Mr. Hermann, let me get this right then. You are saying that you don't agree with the whole process of splitting Eskom up, but do you believe then it is a sense of privatization, much like some of the other unions?
We don't think that splitting up is necessarily a form of privatization. We are not in principle against the splitting up of Eskom. We think it can make it more efficient. The problem that we have at this stage is that we have only a very vague release on that. We don't know what the content of that. We don't know what's the meaning of that. We don't know will it lead to privatization. So very little information is available. Now, we're meeting next week with the minister, and hopefully there will be more clarity on that.
Yeah, more clarity is also expected to come through from the finance minister's budget speech, which is expected out as well next week, Wednesday. So perhaps more word should come from that. Dirk Hermann, the CEO of Solidarity, appreciate your time as well this afternoon on Point. We'll continue.